This is my planning tank, and I had to hastily put my pyro trimacs in. And they doing good. As you would know, as soon as I pick up the camera, they all disappear on me. There's one under that wood down there, and one right there. Well, let me get a couple of them to pay up.
A woman spent the night at her mother's house, and when she arrived home the next day at her apartment, she found the front door had been kicked in. She was frantic because her roommate, Stacy Hendricks, was nowhere to be found.
At first glance, a motive for the break-in is unclear.
This door had been kicked in, but when we came into the apartment, we found no sign of burglary, no sign of the struggle.
But when he examines the missing woman's room, Reed finds some ominous clues. Stacy's locked bedroom door has been forced open, and her bed covers are missing.
Stacy's roommate was quite concerned that there had been a kidnapping.
And if Stacy has been taken, Detective Reed now learns she is in deadly peril, not only from her kidnapper. 21-year-old Stacy Hendrickson has been battling an illness all her life. Juvenile diabetes.
Two of the smallest ones who I had, they should be females. That's one.
We found that her insulin was still in the refrigerator, and that without that insulin, she could slip into some type of diabetic shock or coma. So we knew we had a race against time.
At most, Stacy can survive 48 hours. There's no time to lose. Officers start at the apartment complex, and they get lucky. A witness in the apartment has seen something through his people.
Earlier, just after 2 a.m., he saw a white man in his mid-20s knock lightly on the door. Then he saw this man pounding on the door and ultimately kick the door open. In his mind, this was possibly a domestic situation.
Stacy had known the